Returning to an aircraft carrier during World War II was an exceptionally challenging task for naval aviators. Unlike modern aviation, which benefits from advanced navigational aids and communication systems, pilots in the 1940s had to rely on rudimentary tools, their skills, and a great deal of improvisation. Without visual landmarks, pilots had no reference points to determine their location, and failing to find the carrier meant ditching the aircraft. Even if the crew survived an emergency water landing and managed to get into a raft, they faced a bleak outlook. Before World War II, the US Navy recognized the necessity for a better navigation system to help carrier-based aircraft locate their ships in the open ocean. They developed and deployed the YEZB high-rake system to address this need. The letters YEZB were simply equipment designations without specific meaning, and high-rake likely referred to the shape of the transmitting antenna. The design specification for the YEZB system required it to transmit a signal that could be received by aircraft flying at 15,000 feet from a distance of 275 miles. This system was tested in early 1938 during a fleet exercise with the USS Saratoga and some of its planes equipped with YEZB. The Navy was so impressed with the results that it decided to equip all carriers and carrier aircraft with this particular system. And here's how it works. The YE stands for the part of the system installed on the carrier. It was an antenna which was located as high on the aircraft carrier as possible that rotated slowly with approximate speed of 2 rpm in a clockwise direction, beaming a homing signal. If an aircraft was in range, the beam swept over it about every 30 seconds. The ZB was a receiver on the Allied aircraft. It was a simple radio receiver that did not have a directional antenna. It could not physically determine the direction of the signal. So how did the pilots determine their position? The idea was pretty simple and clever. The YE transmitter was designed to transmit 12 different Morse code letters as the antenna rotated through 360 degrees. Each of the 12 Morse code letters corresponded to a 30-degree slice of the compass. A pilot or a radio operator in an aircraft hearing the signal of a given letter could determine which piece of the compass his position was on and what heading to take to get back to the ship. In this example, the pilot of the plane, hearing the letter G, knew that he should take a heading between 0 and 30 degrees to reach the aircraft carrier. If he heard, for example, the letter F or H on the way back, this would be a signal for him to make a heading correction accordingly. Eventually, he'd get within visual range of the carrier, at which point he could switch off the ZB receiver. Of course, in order to prevent the enemy from tracking down the aircraft carrier, the letters corresponding to a particular sector were classified and changed every day. Pilots received information about them during each pre-flight briefing. That made the system very secure, and the Imperial Japanese Navy until the end of the war could not figure out how the American pilots were able to find their way back to their carriers. That's it for today. If you like this type of presentation and would like to see more, please support this channel by leaving like or comment, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you next time.